What long-term data, including overall survival, are available for Jakafi, ruxolitinib, in the treatment of certain types of myelofibrosis? This video is intended for informational use only and is not designed to replace the medical advice of your healthcare professional.
Hi, I'm Dr. Gary Grad, a hematologist-oncologist based in the Chicago area. I treat patients with myelofibrosis, or MF, and other conditions in my practice. Jakafi, ruxolitinib, is a prescription medicine available as a pill.
Jakafi is the first prescription medicine approved by the FDA for the treatment of adults with intermediate or high-risk MF.
In order to better understand how medicines may work and what side effects they may cause, researchers perform clinical trials, sometimes by comparing new treatments with existing treatments, and sometimes comparing to a placebo or sugar pill. Two clinical trials were conducted to evaluate Jakafi in the treatment of patients with intermediate 2 or high-risk myelofibrosis. In one clinical trial, Jakafi was compared with placebo or sugar pill, and in the other, Jakafi was compared with best available therapy, which included other treatments used for MF. In both trials, Jakafi was better able to reduce spleen size in patients with enlarged spleens. In the first trial, when measured after 6 months of treatment, Jakafi reduced the size of the spleen by 35% or more in 42% of patients with MF. By contrast, less than 1% of people taking a placebo or sugar pill reached that goal. In the second trial, Jakafi also reduced the size of the spleen in more patients than best available therapy. You can see the results for both trials in the full prescribing information or by asking your healthcare professional. In the first trial, 99% of people on Jakafi had a reduction in spleen size, even if it was less than the 35% goal achieved by some patients. By contrast, most patients receiving placebo or sugar pill experienced an increase in spleen size.
Jakafi is used to treat adults with intermediate or high-risk myelofibrosis, MF. Important safety information is discussed later in this video.
We're going to focus now on some other data from these trials. Results from clinical trials can be complex, and understanding the data can be challenging. If you have questions, make sure to talk to your healthcare professional about these data to help you understand. Every person is unique. How your MF progresses and how you may respond to Jakafi depends on your individual circumstances. Recall I said earlier that these patients were initially observed for a number of months in the two clinical trials we've been reviewing. The patients continued to be observed for several years with the goal of seeing how long they lived. In fact, the clinical trial required that these patients be checked at regular time points of 1, 2, and 3 years. Researchers used the data collected at 1, 2, and 3 years to generate a special type of graph that healthcare professionals use to understand estimates of survival. This graph is called a Kaplan-Meier curve, and it shows the likelihood that patients in the trial would still be alive at certain time points. This is known as a survival probability. You can find the Kaplan-Meier curve for both trials and the full prescribing information for Jakafi that is available online. Remember to talk to your healthcare professional to help you understand this information. Kaplan-Meier curves help to show the estimated likelihood of survival for patients who either started the clinical trials being treated with Jakafi or started on placebo or best available therapy. In both clinical trials, all patients receiving placebo or best available therapy were eventually switched to treatment with Jakafi or discontinued from the study. Along with the Kaplan-Meier curves, you'll find a list of percentages. The researchers in the first clinical trial estimated the probability that patients would still be alive at 1, 2, and 3 years following the start of the trial. At 3 years, survival probability was estimated to be 70% for patients who started the trial taking Jakafi and 61% for those who started the trial taking a placebo. Similar data are shown here for the second trial. At 3 years, survival probability was estimated to be 79% for patients who started the clinical trial taking Jakafi and 59% for those who started on best available therapy. In order to really understand these data and what they may mean, you should speak with your healthcare professional so that he or she can explain the results to you. Every person is unique. How you may respond to Jakafi depends on your individual circumstances. Talk to your healthcare professional to learn more about the safety of Jakafi and how patients responded to the medication in clinical trials.
Important safety information. Jakafi can cause serious side effects, including low blood counts, Jakafi, ruxolitinib, may cause low platelet, red blood cell, and white blood cell counts. If you develop bleeding, stop taking Jakafi and call your healthcare provider. Your healthcare provider will do a blood test to check your blood counts before you start Jakafi and regularly during your treatment. Your healthcare provider may change your dose of Jakafi or stop your treatment based on the results of your blood tests. Tell your healthcare provider right away if you develop or have worsening symptoms such as unusual bleeding, bruising, tiredness, shortness of breath, or a fever. Infection. You may be at risk for developing a serious infection during treatment with Jakafi. Tell your healthcare provider if you develop any of the following symptoms of infection: chills, nausea, vomiting, aches, weakness, fever, painful skin rash, or blisters. Cancer. Some people have had certain types of non-melanoma skin cancers during treatment with Jakafi. Your healthcare provider will regularly check your skin during your treatment with Jakafi. Tell your healthcare provider if you develop any new or changing skin lesions during treatment with Jakafi. Increases in cholesterol. You may have changes in your blood cholesterol levels during treatment with Jakafi. Your healthcare provider will do blood tests to check your cholesterol levels about every 8 to 12 weeks after you start taking Jakafi and as needed. Increased risk of major cardiovascular events such as heart attack, stroke, or death in people who have cardiovascular risk factors and who are current or past smokers while using another JAK inhibitor to treat rheumatoid arthritis. Get emergency help right away if you have any symptoms of a heart attack or stroke while taking Jakafi, including discomfort in the center of your chest that lasts for more than a few minutes or that goes away and comes back, severe tightness, pain, pressure, or heaviness in your chest, throat, neck, or jaw, pain or discomfort in your arms, back, neck, jaw, or stomach, shortness of breath with or without chest discomfort, breaking out in a cold sweat, nausea or vomiting, feeling lightheaded, weakness in one part or on one side of your body, slurred speech. Increased risk of blood clots. Blood clots in the veins of your legs, deep vein thrombosis, DVT, or lungs, pulmonary embolism, PE, have happened in people taking another JAK inhibitor for rheumatoid arthritis and may be life-threatening. Tell your healthcare provider right away if you have any signs and symptoms of blood clots during treatment with Jakafi, including swelling, pain, or tenderness in one or both legs, sudden unexplained chest or upper back pain, shortness of breath, or difficulty breathing. Possible increased risk of new secondary cancers. People who take another JAK inhibitor for rheumatoid arthritis have an increased risk of new secondary cancers, including lymphoma and other cancers. People who smoke or smoked in the past have an added risk of new cancers. The most common side effects of Jakafi include, for certain types of myelofibrosis, MF, and polycythemia vera, PV, low platelet or red blood cell counts, bruising, dizziness, headache, and diarrhea. For acute GVHD, low platelet counts, low red or white blood cell counts, infections, and swelling. And for chronic GVHD, low red blood cell or platelet counts and infections, including viral infections. These are not all the possible side effects of Jakafi. Ask your pharmacist or healthcare provider for more information. Call your doctor for medical advice about side effects. Before taking Jakafi, tell your healthcare provider about all the medications, vitamins, and herbal supplements you are taking and all your medical conditions, including if you have an infection, have or had low white or red blood cell counts, have or had tuberculosis, TB, or have been in close contact with someone who has TB, had shingles, herpes zoster, have or had hepatitis B, have or had liver or kidney problems, are on dialysis, have high cholesterol or triglycerides, had cancer, are a current or past smoker, had a blood clot, heart attack, other heart problems, or stroke, or have any other medical condition. Take Jakafi exactly as your healthcare provider tells you. Do not change your dose or stop taking Jakafi without first talking to your healthcare provider. Women should not take Jakafi while pregnant or planning to become pregnant. Do not breastfeed during treatment with Jakafi and for 2 weeks after the final dose. please see the full prescribing information, which includes a more complete discussion of the risks associated with Jakafi. You are encouraged to report negative side effects of prescription drugs to the FDA. Visit www.fda.gov/medwatch or call 1-800-FDA-1088. You may also report side effects to Insight Medical Information at 1-855-463-3463.